over the years, yeah.
Came together. Mm-hmm. What was like the first actual project that you worked on together?
Damn.
I mean, as far as lucrative or just like bullshitting around?
Lucrative, like, you know, some kind of name.
No, I know in the earlier days, because we've worked together, then we've done our own thing, then we started a production company together. Lucrative? It might have been, was it Las Vegas, the film? The Robert De Niro film?
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. So what did you guys do? Did you guys, like, do, like, the score for the movie or, like, a song?
We do one of the records that's in a couple scenes in that film.
And, yeah.
That was the first time I saw what those checks look like as far as like the upfront. I was like, oh, okay. Yeah. Movies might be the way.
And then how did you get into working with the actual artist? Like, how did you
across that? Just networking.
Yeah.
You know, that's the name of the game. You just got to network, go out, meet people. So, and that's just how it happened. Like, somebody knew somebody who knew somebody just put us in with the artist, so.
Yeah. Who's your favorite artist that you've worked with so far?
Okay, so it's either, because you know how a lot of times being a writer, you don't actually get to be in the studio when they cut the songs, which is weird.
Yeah.
But if I was to say indirectly, I would say Charlie Wilson. I cut a record of Charlie Wilson, but I wasn't in the session.
Yeah.
So that was one of those ones where I was like, oh.
Yeah. Charlie's a good one. That was Chasing Cities. What about you, Kyle?
I mean, I cut a record on Slim from 112.
Wow.
And the whole time I was like, yo, this is the nigga that got me laid in middle school. Peaches and cream.
Oh,
so he
God.
Was dope as
you
hell.
Know what
the
I
fact
mean.
That you said got laid in middle school is crazy. I'm just letting you know that.
Listen, I started young.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's
but,
crazy.
You know, yeah, Slim was dope, man. He's hella cool. Like,
yeah. Is there like an artist that either like individually or together that you guys want to work with that you haven't already?
I mean, Pharrell. I
mean, oh my God, he's a good one.
There's so many people though. I mean, yeah, I don't, it's so many people.
Like, you don't have a wish list, like somebody that you...
My wish list changes every hour.
Really? So what does it depend on, Chasing Cities? What does your wish list depend on
I
why
love,
it changes?
I mean, I would want to work with Jay-Z, then I want to work with Celine Dion. You know what I'm saying? I want to work with everybody. Like,
right, yeah.
I'd work it with Enrique, then I'd work with Beyonce. Like, it's... Talent is talent no matter what genre. So I get a certain type of feeling from certain incredible artists no matter what genre they're in. So
right.
What about you, Kyle?
I mean, I said it. I definitely want to work with Pharrell, like, you know.
So for you, he's like the steady guy.
I mean, the ones that's alive, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, so.
If you could bring someone from the dead, who would it be?
Prince.
Oh, my God. He's, I love Prince. Oh, my God, I love Prince.
Yeah.
How about you, Chase?
I'm going to have to go with Tupac. That's,
oh, my God, yes.
That's what I'm on right now.
Yeah. Do you guys want to know something?
Hmm. You dated Tupac.
He asked me out, but I turned him down.
Wow. I had a feeling this was going there.
He did. He like asked me out, and I said no.
Why?
You know.
Was he Tupac at that time or?
No, he was Tupac. Oh, okay. I'm talking about like this goes back like to the like the 90s. Mm-hmm. I was 18 years old working at William Morris Agency, and that's the agency that represented him, Michael Gruber. Michael Gruber was his agent, and every single day Tupac would come over and he would beg his agent to set up a date with me. And Michael Gruber would always, like, Elizabeth, Tupac wants to go with you. Can you please, please just go out with him? Like, I understand you may not like him, but can you please just like at least one date? And I was like, I don't want to. But you know what? Here's, you know how you go through phases of like, when you like certain race, you know, to date and others you don't. Mm-hmm. Back then, you know, it's like I had many, many, many friends that, you know, were black as friends, but no one that I was interested in dating, you know. So in that phase, I dated everything except black. Mm-hmm. Then cut to like in the, like 2000, like actually like in 1990.
You caught the Young Jungle fever, huh?
Exactly.
She went to the safari and was like, it's cracking over here. I should have did this sooner.
Right. And then that's when I was like, God damn, I just missed an opportunity to just be with Tupac.
Oh, shit.
You would have went down a legend.
Really?
That would have been legendary.
Yeah. Oh, my God, yeah. But to tell the story is kind of nice, too, because, you know, it's like, I didn't. And then, like, with Prince, mm-hmm. Prince, he's somebody that I never, ever, ever was interested in mm-hmm. because, you know, he just seemed too feminine for me. Right. It wasn't until like in the late 90s where it was like in the 2000s. Then I was like, I started feeling Prince. I was like, he looks kind of sexy. Yeah, maybe I wouldn't mind. So I went to one of his concerts over at the Forum, mm-hmm. like the ones that he had. I think it might have been like 5 years ago or something. I went to his concert and I went by myself and I decided to get like a table. And I was there and the entire night, Prince was singing to me the entire night. Like when he was like right, like because he was like right there, he was singing to me, and that was like the time when he would bring mm-hmm. women on stage, and during that time, like he all of a sudden called me on stage.
Oh damn!
Yeah, so I missed my chance with him too because you know I was by myself, I wasn't drinking because I was gonna drive, and all of a sudden like he's singing and I'm like he's doing this to me with his finger, mm-hmm. and I'm like okay, he is not talking to me. I know it's not me, okay. And of course like he keeps doing this, and then I look behind me and I was like. Shit, there's nobody behind me. He's talking to me. And I went like this. I'm like, me? And he's like, and I was like, oh, no.
Oh, wow.
So I did that. I started saying no. I was like, no. And then after that, he never sang to me again. Like, he was singing right here. Then he was singing over there to, like, the right and left. Like, he ignored me the rest of the night. And I was like, fuck. That could have been my night that I would have been with him.
Damn, man. That's crazy.
I know.
Man, double it.
But that's okay.
It's okay.
That's okay because I wasn't added to their, you know, list of many, you know, under their belts of, you know, people that
can't have that attitude.
Yeah, not the way.
Well, no, you know what? This is why I was telling you that, like with Prince, I finally decided that I wanted to, but then it was just a bad timing, for, you know, because I was by myself and I'm really shy when it comes to like being in front of people like mm-hmm. that. I'm shy. It was like an entire audience.
You should have just said, fuck it.
You know what? If I would have had a drink, I would have said, fuck it. But because I was driving, you know, I just didn't.
Yeah.
That's
crazy.
Like, next time I know.
Boy, it's not going to be next time with Prince.
No, not with Prince. Not with Prince, with, you know, like somebody okay. else. Like, right. somebody else now, I'm going to say, you know what? See, this is why I took that date with that guy, because I didn't want to have, I was like, you know what? Maybe, you know, you never know. I was like, I should just go with this guy. Like, go on this date just in case.
Well, man.
So let's play one of your songs that you're promoting.
Yeah, yeah. I have a single coming out next week with Adrian Marcel called None of Your Friends' Business, mm-hmm. Produced by Sounds, and we wrote it.
Yes.
So, you know, that's about to drop next week. Make sure you check out the SoundCloud, soundcloud.com/K Chris Music.
Add up, baby.
Ain't none of your friends' business. 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 Ain't none of your friends' business.
No, 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 no.
Ain't none of your friends' business. Ain't none of your friends' business.
No, 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 no.
You know that I'm feeling you, though I'm not your dud. Hop your ass up in the car. You already know the way we do. My situation got no rules. You call me when you in the mood. Nobody finish what we doing, girl, you know it's between me and you. So up now, it's about to go down, go down. After you done took rounds, you feel it,
oh yeah.
It's going up now, it's about to go down, go down.
By the way you're moving, you feel the same way, yeah.
Ain't none of your friends' business, ain't none of your friends' business.
No, 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 no.
Friends business.
No, 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 no.
Ain't none of your friends' business. Ain't none of your friends' business.
this for show. And we ain't doing this for goals. And we ain't doing this for Instagram, just to show up and flex on a post. Niggas be doing the most, but you know when I get you alone. It's going up now, it's about to go down, go down. After you done took rounds, you feel it, oh yeah. It's going up now, it's about to go down By the way you're moving, you feel the same way, yeah.
Ain't none of your friends business, ain't none of your friends business.
No, 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 no.
Ain't none of your friends business,
ain't none of your friends business.
You're listening to the show. My name is Elizabeth, and the song you just heard right now is None of Your Friends' Business, and that is with Kyle Christopher and
Adrian Marcel.
Yes. Thank you. So what other projects do you guys have right now that is like cooking?
We have like a bunch of stuff that we're developing right now. Some of it, it's like we...
You want to say yet?
It's too early.
Yeah.
I don't want to like throw it out there yet before we, you know...
You don't want to jinx
all
it.
The business. Cause right. You know what I'm saying? But we're developing a few different cool things.
Right. And then we just had a record come out with Adrian Marcel, mm-hmm. featuring Lil Boosie, Too Short, and M City Jr. called Mobbin. So you should start hearing that. Being spun on the radio.
Is that like playing now on the radio?
Yeah. Just starting to just go to stations and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah. We actually wrote and produced half the project. So.
Wow.
Yeah.
Do you have the song with you?
Of his?
Yeah.
I have it.
You have it.
Yeah, I do have it.
Okay, so then you know what? We're going to go ahead and we'll play it.
Okay.
So then they could listen to it. And if where can they find this song? If they wanted to download it.
I don't even know if it's available for download yet.
So right now it's just like radio and right then now, it'll be available.
You know, the
okay.
whole, it's yes. going through the new attunes
right.
and all of that stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so they played it on Power, so you'll start.
They're playing it in the Bay a little bit now.
Yeah. Because
he's from the Bay, he's from Oakland.
Mm-hmm.
And
Too Short, right?
K-M-E-L is
yeah.
playing it a little bit and stuff
yeah.
like that, so... It's the beginning stages of breaking a record, so we'll see what happens.
Okay, so you guys, this is the first time that, so you've heard it on terrestrial radio, which is now barely playing, and it's not available for download, so you can, you're going to hear it now, and this is the name of?
Adrian Marcel, Mobbin, featuring Too Short, Boosie, and M City Jr.
If you guys like it, you better download it when it's available and add it to your playlist. So here's the song, we'll be right back.
Pull up to the function, no roof. Real in the trunk, smoking loud, granddad. Bouncers know the deal, we just walking straight through. I'm with my day ones, my niggas, my fam. Every time you see me, I be chilling with a few when they all bad. You know niggas hate it when you popping and they lose, got them all mad. To the function, too cool. Shit, I'm on, got me feeling like I can't lose.
Well,
tonight, we mobbing, we mobbing, we mobbing, we mobbing. Oh, it's on. I got hella options in your town tonight.
Every time you see me, I be chillin' with a few when they all bad.